Hi, everyone. My name's Ben Backwell, and I'm the CEO of the Global Wind Energy Council. Today is Global Wind Day, and today we are launching the Wind Energy Coalition for COP26, the climate negotiations which will take place in November this year in Glasgow. Like many people, my hope is that 2021 will be remembered as the year when the world finally got serious about climate change and started moving decisively to do something about it. Now, many solutions will be needed to stop dangerous climate change, but wind power is a particularly important part of the large scale and virtually limitless clean energy source. It holds the most decarbonisation potential of any renewable energy technology. Wind energy has already transformed economies and communities, creating clean energy and high-value jobs in the places that they are most needed. There's now more than 743 gigawatts of global installed wind capacity, which already helps the world avoid 1.1 billion tons of carbon emissions. But much more is needed. Recent reports by both the International Energy Agency and the International Renewable Energy Agency see wind, along with solar PV, as playing the leading role in achieving net zero targets and decarbonizing the global energy system. To do this, we need to increase wind power capacity to over 8 terawatts by 2050. And to achieve this, we need to be installing wind power at around 3 or 4 times the current annual rate. Now, I know that as an industry, we have the passion, the know-how, and the commitment to scale up our efforts. But we can't do this alone. At present, there's plenty of appetite for wind energy as investors and companies seek to switch from fossil fuels to clean energy. And that we know that we have strong support from people and communities all around the world. But governments are too often taking a business as usual approach. And we are held back by red tape, bureaucratic delays, and energy systems that were built for the fossil age. We need a new approach if we are going to build an energy system that's fit for the future. And if we are going to create millions of jobs that building a clean energy system will require. The time for warm words and faraway targets is over. We need to act right now to let investment flow and help unlock the transformative power of wind. Over the coming months, we'll be working together with governments, critical industries, and other stakeholders and partners on turning good intentions into real progress on the ground. I hope all of you will join us on this journey.